Now today, if you go to listen to other people, they can't differentiate, they can't appreciate these things. They will always say, Iman is the first. Where this first Iman has come from? Who gave you this Iman? Is there anybody who can claim that I received Iman directly from Allah? If anybody has received Iman directly from Allah, then he can say the first blessing is Iman. Nobody received Quran directly from Allah. Nobody received Islam from Allah. Nobody get the cognizance and the marifah of Kaaba from Allah. Nobody received the halal and haram from Allah. Nobody received hidayah from Allah. Nothing. The people, they were lost in the idols, in statues. They had hundreds of gods, self-made gods. They had no concept of Iman and Tawheed and no concept of hidayah and guidance. This was Holy Prophet Muhammad who was raised. And he invited the people to believe in him, in his Nabuwwah and in his Risalah by the command of Almighty Allah. So those who believed in him, those who accepted him is Allah, as Allah's messenger, only they were able to be led to Iman. So by believing in Holy Prophet ﷺ, he held the hands of the people, of his believers and Ummah, and he led them to Iman and Hidayah. He led them to Iman because he was the caller. He was the one who invited them to Iman. Tell me, if you are invited to a particular dinner, dinner comes first or invitation comes first? Who comes first? Very simple thing. You are invited here to listen to the lecture, to participate here. You are participating. So participation has come first or an invitation letter has come first? You are invited. So who invited the mankind to Iman? To the dinner of Iman. To the beauty of Iman. To participate in this beautiful proximity, qurbat of Iman. Who invited? The one who invites the people to guidance, to Iman and faith is known as the Rasul, the messenger. He invited the people to Iman in Almighty Allah. Aminu bi Rabbikum. O people, come on and believe there is a Lord who have created you. Lat is not your God. Manat is not your Rabb. Uzza and Hubal, these are not your God, self-created. The statues are not your God. They are not worthy of being worshipped. Come, I tell you, here is your Lord, the one who created the whole world, who is the cherisher of the whole world, who is the most merciful, who is the compassionate, ever merciful. He is the God. Come, I tell you this way. So he invited. He gave a call. He invited the people. Those who said labbaik on his invitation. But when you received the invitation letter, did you reply or not? You confirmed, said, yes, we are coming by your email. When you, through your email, said, yes, we are coming. This is means labbaik. We accept your invitation. So those who accepted the invitation of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, they became mu'min. And those who became mu'min, they were offered to sit here. They were offered the dinner. This is a common process in the whole areas, all areas of your life. Same happens in Islam. Now, let me, after this example, now we come to Quran. The same thing has been explained in Quran. The people were in complete darkness. The people, Quran says, were in complete darkness. Surah Al-Jumu'ah, verse number 2. Almighty Allah says, إِن كَانُوا مِن قَبْلُ لَفِي ضَلَالٍ مُبِينٍ. Indeed, they were in open error, in open darkness, open misguidance before his most welcome arrival of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Before the most welcomed and honored arrival of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the people were in open error, in open darkness and misguidance. So it is declared that the people were in ad-dalalul mubin. Then how were they invited and how they reached to the blessing of Iman? Quran says, Surah Al-Imran, Al Imran number 193. A'udhu billahi minash shaitan. Beautiful verse. Rabbana innana sami'na munadiya. Rabbana innana sami'na munadiyan yunadi lil iman an aminu bi rabbikum fa amanna. This is the whole thing has been clarified. O our Lord, we were oblivious of you, totally ignorant. We were lost in darkness of misguidance. Then we heard a caller. This is Quran. Now I am determining who is first, the Prophet and Messenger Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam or Iman Billah. Who comes first? Most of the people don't understand these orders and priorities, and those who stand little bit, they don't feel courage to say. Now my second purpose would be to bring you out of the complex and of inferiority, to give you a courage of Iman with the ilm of and ma'rif of Quran and Sunnah, so that you may understand whatever we believe is based on Quran and Sunnah. This is not something which you have just got from your parents, from Trinidad, you brought from Trinidad, and you brought from Guyana, and you brought from India, and you brought from here and there. No, this is something which was sent us to from Makkah and Medina in the form of guidance of Quran and Sunnah. Some people think, but these are the things which were old parents or ancestors, they were ignorant people, jahil people, and they have been giving these to you. Now we have come to the light of Quran and Sunnah. The position is reversed. This is jahala. The light of Quran and Sunnah is that says, O our Lord, we were totally ignorant. We were lost in the darkness of misguidance. We were oblivious of you. Then we heard a caller. Now I am explaining the priority, stepwise. Who comes first, who comes afterwards, who comes third, number three. This is the order, this sequence is Iman. Then we heard a caller. So who comes first? The thing which he is calling you to, that comes first, or the caller comes first? Then this is the Quranic order. Then we heard a caller. And who is the caller? Prophet, Messenger, sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam. We heard a caller. What was he doing? He was calling towards faith. He was calling us towards Iman. We never knew what Iman was. We had no clue of Iman. We heard him, he was calling towards faith. Yunadi lil Iman. He was calling us to faith. And what was he saying? What was his message? His message was, An aminu bi rabbikum. Oh people, come here and believe in your Lord. He was inviting us to believe in Almighty Allah. So the target is not yet achieved. They have not yet arrived at the destination. They have not yet arrived at the destination. They are still in their way. They heard the caller, and the message he was giving was, come on towards the faith. And when we went close to him in his company and we heard, he was inviting, come on, believe in your Lord. This was his message. And then when we heard from him, we accepted his invitation, believe in your Lord. So we embraced Iman. This is the Quran. So we embraced Iman. So we embraced faith. So now, is there any ambiguity on this subject? Who comes first and who comes afterwards? This is the status of Risala, of Rasul. Everything comes afterwards. And don't get confused. There should be no misunderstanding on that. Let me correct if any ambiguity arises out of that by misunderstanding, that I don't mean that mazallah, Allah, his status is mazallah, astaghfirullah, comes after Holy Prophet Muhammad. If anybody thinks like that, he will become kafir. Allah is the creator. He is the Lord. He is the one who sent his messenger. And his messengers are from human beings. Prophets and messengers, his chosen beloved people. There is no question of the grades or station. He is makhluk and he is khaliq. No question, no comparison. I am talking of tartibul iman. Tartibu husulil iman. Tartibu wusulil iman. What is the order of achieving or of receiving the iman? Tartibul wusul. That is, that messenger comes first from everything, prior to everything. Then he leads us to God, to believe in him. When you become the believer and you mention, since Allah is Allah and Rasul is his beloved prophet and his human being, so then you mention the name of Almighty Allah first and Holy Prophet's name after that. This is because of respect, the order of honor, the order of grade and rank. But when you talk of the priority, the way the methodology, methodologically speaking, this is how the iman comes. Then in other Quranic verse, Quran says, Holy Prophet is the means which leads you to iman and hidayah. So how you say that we accept iman, we accept Quran, we accept everything and don't accept in the authority that Holy Prophet Muhammad has said other than Quran? So you are turning the whole story. This becomes kufr. The one who invited you to Quran, the one who introduced you to Quran, the one who invited you and called you towards Almighty Allah's recognition, you are accepting everything which he gave to you, which he introduced to you, which he provided to you, which he was raised with to you. You are accepting authority of everything. And you are rejecting the authority of his own saying, who became the basic means of your connection to Almighty Allah in his Kalam in Quran. So the denial of authority of Sunnah and the denial of authority of the sayings of Prophet Muhammad leads to denial of everything. Neither faith in Quran, then is saved. Nor faith in Allah is saved, nor faith in Islam is saved. Everything will go away. Because that was the foundation. وَإِنَّكَ لَتَهْدِي إِلَىٰ صِرَاطِ مُسْتَقِيمِ. This is Quran. Oh my beloved Prophet and my beloved Messenger, you are the who? You are the one alone. إِنَّكَ, and assuredly, you alone provide guidance towards the straight path. This is Quran. وَإِنَّكَ لَتَهْدِي إِلَىٰ صِرَاطِ مُسْتَقِيمِ. And definitely, O my beloved Prophet, you alone provide guidance towards the straight path. So here Quran has said, who is the provider of guidance? Almighty Allah is provider of guidance, but here Holy Prophet has been declared to be the providers of guidance. وَاللَّهُ يَهْدِي مَنْ يَشَاءُ إِلَىٰ صِرَاطِ مُسْتَقِيمِ. Almighty Allah is the one who provides guidance to the straight path. This is Quran. But here, can you accept one ayah and reject the other? Is this would be iman? Nu'minu bi ba'din wa nakfuru bi ba'd. We believe in some of the verses and we disbelieve in some of the verses. This is kufr. You have to believe the Quran in totality. And if you find different things, this is our limitation of mind or wrong teachings which we are carrying from our last audiences, you can say, hearing. We have to correct our views. We have to, that's why we have established this sitting, to correct the views, to remove the erroneous things from our mind, root them out.